opened just before Christmas in 1926, a movie palace designed in the opulent style of theaters in New York and Atlanta, with velvet seats, sparkling chandeliers, ornate moldings, and rich colors. Named the Tivoli Theater, like so many of its day, this one was different. This one was ours. And at 81 years young, she's still shining as brightly as ever.
One of the things that's really interesting about this building is that it was built right sort of on the cusp of the growing interest in premium placed on motion pictures. And so it was designed both for exhibiting movies as well as live stage performances.
There were three movie theaters in Frederick. There was this one, which was the Grand Place, and they always had the best movies. And then in the City Hall, where now is that Brewer's Alley, in the back was the movie house, and that was the opera house. And on weekends, they always had a Western, an odor movie.
I've never heard that term.
Odor?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you don't do crossword puzzles.
When my mother took me to the movies when I was 6 years old at the Tivoli in downtown Frederick to see a Shirley Temple movie. That was a great memory of the Tivoli. I'm not a great movie fan, but I did remember Shirley Temple.
Yeah, when you stood up there and you threw your jacket or whatever up to that lamp.
Did it get stuck up there?
Yeah.
It did?
Yeah, you threw it off that balcony.
Really?
Chandelier. They had to climb up there in a ladder.
I'd forgotten that. Popcorn was accounted for by the number of bags that were sold, not by the amount of popcorn. And so as long as we had our own bag, we could have all the popcorn we wanted. I think the same was true with soft drinks.
I think so too.
We could have as many Cokes as we wanted, but we couldn't have a cup.
One of the things that makes the Weinberg Center for the Arts so unique is the beautiful Wurlitzer organ. While the original console was damaged beyond repair in the flood of 1976, the organ pipes and instruments escaped harm. It's the only organ of its kind still in its original installation in Maryland, and one of just a handful in the entire country.
And once you play these things, you're addicted to them and you never give up.
It's all good?
Yep. I've been associated with the Weinberg Center since 1960, when it was the Tivoli Theater, as a 20-year-old. Now that tells you I'm 67, all right? And I hope to be associated until one night I have a massive heart attack and fall off the bench and hit the floor, and so forth, okay? What a way to go, though, all right? So, anyway. I love it. It's not a large instrument, but in this theater, it sounds three times larger than it really is.
I always just loved coming into the theater and hearing the organ played. Just many days we would come in with our father, or our mother would bring us to town for something, and we would stop in the morning before the theater opened, and we'd walk in and hear the organ playing, and I just love that. And my father actually arranged for Dick to meet with me on certain Saturdays I've forgotten what age I was, where I would actually go and sit on the bench with him, and he would show me how to, all the different stops and all the different buttons and how to work everything, and I just love that.
You see where people have come back and gotten married here. There's so many stories of the different experiences that people have had here, which is what gives it its history, and it's what gives it its heart and soul, and it's really how it's, has stayed in this, woven itself into the community.
What we just did today, this morning, we had almost 1,000 kids in here seeing an educational program, many for the first time, any kind of performing arts. That's always exciting to see.
The essence of performing arts is taking that which is in the heart
and putting it out in front of people, risking acceptance or non-acceptance of it, and then appreciating the applause that comes with it.
I love that moment when the lights go down and you're sitting in the darkness just for a few seconds, and you can actually hear the audience breathe. And it's such a wonderful feeling. Those are my favorite moments.
There have been a million special moments on the Weinberg stage, thanks to the talent and dedication of thousands of artists.
We had wonderful people on this stage. Dennis Hughes, Roger Nicodemus, Steve Pamango. They're not with us anymore. But they embraced the kids in this town and the people in this town, and gave the audiences in this town an opportunity to see some of the best shows that have ever been.
I think it's just thrilling when, as far as local performances, you know, to see the local groups performing here. And I know when my daughter was growing up, and I kept thinking, you know, I wonder if she'll ever get a chance to, you know, be up there on the stage. And sure enough, when she was in Frederick Children's Chorus, and she was picked, and she was one of the, and I mean, I just can't tell you how thrilled I was sitting in the audience, seeing her, you know, up on the stage at the Weinberg Center, you know, named for her grandparents. And I'm sure everybody, you know, has children or any member of their family who gets the chance to perform here, like he says, with the history that goes along with the arts and Frederick. It's a wonderful experience, and I hope everybody will try to take advantage of that.
Over the years, many local theater groups have taken advantage of the Grand Theater, including the Fredericktown Players, Beneath My Wings, Octorian Theater Company, Other Voices, and Maryland Regional Ballet.
I actually started when my daughter was three. She was in ballet, and it was just an amazing opportunity for her to get up on stage. She's been here every year, and you know, she's nine now, and it's like the Weinberg Center for her is just like, you know, part of Frederick.
It is because the Weinberg Center is so important to Frederick's character, enhancing the lives of thousands of Fredericktonians, that many feel passionately about supporting its endeavors.
How confusing, if I can't believe what I see with my own eyes.
Eyes aren't enough. For true vision, you must see with your heart, Alice.
I'm the person that needs to support the Weinberg Center. I need it to be a part of my life, because it's been a part of my life for a long time.
You know, I feel it needs to be here to stay, and we need to know that it's going to stay, and it's not going anywhere. And I think that, to me, is like, you know, the most important message I could possibly think of. I want my kids to come back when they're adults and say, I used to go there as a, you know, child, and God, look how great it looks.
It doesn't hurt to give. And it will give you a good feeling.
It does.
There were three gentlemen there. Mr. Jack Warner, owner of Warner Movies. W.L. Brand, the owner of Chaladon, who was the horse of the year in 1939 and 1940. And Dr. Eddie Thomas, a well-known surgeon in Frederick, who operated on me twice.
At a pre-race party, Jack Warner was overheard saying he was going to bet $50,000 on the favorite. Dr. Thomas persuaded him to instead bet on Chaladon, a racehorse raised in Walkersville. When Chaladon won the race, Mr. Warner won $175,000.
He felt obligated to do something for Dr. Thomas, since he had given him this hot tip. And Dr. Thomas said, well, I go to the Warner Movie Theater in Frederick, and there's no air conditioning there in the summertime. And that's where I go to relax after surgery. So he said, I'd like to see air conditioning in the Tivoli Theater. And Mr. Warner said, you will have it. And he paid $100,000 to have the Tivoli Theater air conditioned, the first building in Frederick to have commercial air conditioning.
Sound like to you?
What, you mean if I wanted to do something? I would probably come up with a march or something like that, the Weinberg Center March, maybe improvise something.
The term that everybody uses is the jewel of Frederick, and that this jewel needs to be shared. It has to have people come to it. That's what makes the luster of any gem brighter.
I think they thought of it as their legacy to the town that they loved. If it is possible that people who have passed on are still keeping an eye on things in the mortal world, I'm sure they're probably watching. Watching us at this moment.
That's just an improvised march. Never heard it before, you'll never hear it again. Okay.
One of a kind, just like the Grand Dam that inspired it. After surviving 8 decades of adversity, from commercial competition to natural disasters to changes in social appetites, the Weinberg Center for the Arts still shines in downtown Frederick. A home to artists young and not so young. A mecca for silent movie buffs. A stage for local and national performers. This jewel of Frederick has moved gracefully from the Cinema Palace of 1926 to the state-of-the-art Performing Arts Center of today.